And there are two important and related concepts that have to do with the way a software architecture evolves. The first one is architectural drift, which is the introduction of architectural design decisions that are orthogonal to a system's prescriptive architecture. That is, they are not included in, encompassed by, or implied by the prescriptive architecture. And the result of architectural drift is that you start from a clean architecture, like the one that I'm showing here, and then you start adding pieces without following a clear plan. Like, for example, here we add an additional room here, but we don't really do it in the right way, so we need to add something else to keep it stable. And then maybe we want some more room, so we add a tent. And then another side of the house that doesn't really follow the same architecture, but it doesn't matter. We just put it there because we want to expand. And maybe then we want to put something classic there, even though it doesn't really fit the overall design and the overall architecture. So I think you get my point. The fact that the architecture then becomes unnecessarily complex, hard to understand, and ultimately awkward. Just like the one that I'm showing here, that goes from the original building to this final monstrosity. The second concept is architectural erosion, which is the introduction of architectural design decisions that violate a system prescriptive architecture. So in this case, we were introducing decisions that were orthogonal. Here, we're introducing decisions that don't comply with the prescriptive architecture. And the result of architectural erosion is typically a poor architecture, an architecture that is going to have problems in the future. So both architectural drift and architectural erosion take you away in different ways from what you think your software architecture is or should be.